Okay. You're the one who grew these, Senpai.
You can just call me Haru. The seasons are changing soon, so I thought it'd be nice for the plants to change as well. This time, it's a Yusuke Kitagawa production.
All I did was add some... how do I put it? Aesthetic simplicity by balancing the color placement. Furthermore, Haru chose the flowers herself. It will surely be a great bed no matter the arrangement.
I'm looking forward to it.
Why don't we plant you, Mona?
Weren't you a shut-in until just recently?
You'd better photosynthesize while you're here.
Well, let's get started.
Perhaps the snapdragon should go 2 more millimeters to the left.
That's not gonna make a difference.
Hey, you know how we're thinking of the school festival as our celebration party? Anyone else think we should have a real celebration on top of that?
I must agree. It would be not only a celebration, but a welcoming as well. I'd like to do something among ourselves.
Let's do it then! A joint party to celebrate and to welcome Haru!
Oh, you don't have to do that. The school festival is more than enough.
How is everyone else supposed to get excited if the star of the party's not into it?
Well then, how about a night party at Destinyland?
By Destinyland, do you mean that Kingdom of Dreams?
It would be a bit late, but there are some plans that allow us to rent out the park for the night.
The entire park? You're talking about the Destinyland, right?
Didn't you say you'd like to do something amongst ourselves?
I did, but...
Hold on, I'll go check.
She really thinks like a celebrity.
What the heck's she gonna check?
Guys, it looks like it will work!
You're really gonna have it at Destinyland? Not like one of the restaurants, but the entire park?
Even just for one night, the price is insane!
Oh, that won't be a problem. We had originally booked it for a company party, then had to call it off because of the scandal. We'd barely get anything back if we cancel the reservation, so why not take advantage of it?
Wouldn't that be oddly conspicuous, though?
It's still officially under the company's name. We needn't worry.
In that case, let's do this! We'll just celebrate twice as hard today!
I'm sorry for disrupting everyone. You did come to help me, after all. Well, let's get back to it.
So, seriously, how much does it cost?
For real?
That was delicious.
The food was arranged on my plate as though it were paint on a canvas.
The staff brought out this table and food just for us, huh?
I thought if we were going to dine together, It would be better to do it somewhere with a view.
The VIP life is incredible! Not that I'd expect anything else from a private rental.
There really is no one else here.
We are the rulers of the Kingdom of Dreams!
Is this lighting just for our sake as well?
That's right.
It's beautiful.
It's not as beautiful as you.
That's the kind of stuff couples say, right?
Almost anyone would fall for that line in front of a sight like this.
Lady An, this view is not as beautiful as...
Come on, you guys are getting way too excited about this stuff.
You say that like you're not tapping into your inner child too, Ryuji.
This is just because Futaba kept nagging me to put him on.
I did not.
You said something like that. Well, yeah, but...
Whoa, look at you being all obedient. Is the Destinyland charm rubbing off on you?
My, this is so heartwarming.
Honestly, I would have liked to see the parade as well, but given how sudden the request was, they couldn't get enough staff together to do it.
Perhaps that will have to wait until next time.
Either way, this party's totally the best one so far. It's freaking amazing!
I'm glad to see you're enjoying it.
Be careful, Haru. You've shown these guys what luxury means. This'll really raise the bar for our next celebration party.
You're already talking about our next party? Don't you think that's somewhat premature?
Seriously!
That party will be for me!
Still, how do I put this? I met Mona-chan. I got to know you all. Isn't everything going a little too perfectly? It's actually a bit frightening.
You worry too much.
I must just be overly cautious because of my circumstances up till recently. I'm sorry for bringing it up.
Hey, isn't it almost time? You know, for the press conference?
Oh, perfect timing!
Father...
Thank you all for taking time out of your busy schedules to gather here. Today, I'd like to elaborate upon the whole truth behind my company's labor situation. How my employees were forced to work under severe conditions. How lax we were with sanitation. And how my corporation acted as a whole to cover up every facet of this scandal. For all of this, I wholeheartedly apologize.
So are you saying all of this was done under your orders?
Yes, I am solely responsible.
We heard that dozens of your employees were forced to resign due to mysterious illness. Furthermore, these happened to be officials who stood against your proposal for overseas expansion. The same thing also happened to executives at competing companies who were looking to expand abroad. Is all of this true?
Yes.
Was it all coincidence? We'd like some answers.
About that. I have a critical piece of information to announce here today.
Here it comes. Okumura is going to say who's really behind the mental shutdowns.
I...
Okumura-san?
Father? Why did he collapse?
That didn't look right at all.
Don't tell me.
Mona-chan, what's going on?
No, that's impossible. You're right. We followed all the same steps. We made sure we just took the treasure, too.
I should call home.
This isn't our fault, is it? It's been okay all four times so far, ever since Kamoshida.
If we let the shadow live, the real person won't undergo mental shutdown, right?
That's how it should work.
Yeah, it's gotta be.
What's wrong?
This is the same. I remember now. It's just like what happened to my mom.
So this is the moment when mental shutdown occurs.
But why did they target Okumura-san?
Damn it! What the hell's going on here?
I have to go. I'll talk to the staff before I leave. Feel free to take your time.
Haru!
This ain't our fault, right?
I'd like to think so.
Some welcoming party, huh?
I'll get in contact with Haru later. But for today, I think we should all return home.
It's been a while. What are you watching? That's...
This is just a hypothesis. But perhaps Okumura was bitten by his lapdog.
Are you implying that the Phantom Thieves triggered a sudden mental shutdown on Okumura?
There might have been a falling out of sorts, so the Phantom Thieves abandoned a useless employer. And to cover their tracks, they dealt with Okumura.
I hate to bring this up, but I'm actually here about that.
Did you find any evidence?
No. Actually, there's a chance that the party behind these aren't the Phantom Thieves, but someone else.
How do you mean? You were suspecting the Phantom Thieves as well.
It is still hypothetical at this point, but I don't want to rule it out.
We're searching the Okumura residence tomorrow, same with Shujin and its principal. We will find evidence on this, no matter what it takes. By the way, I wanted to ask you something.
Yes?
You haven't looked at my laptop or taken files from it without my permission, have you?
That's quite out of the blue.
There were traces that someone transferred data from it. It was only a small error pop-up, but I noticed it immediately after I had that argument with you last month.
And that's why you suspect me? Oh, please, give me a break.
Are you saying you didn't?
As a detective myself, I honor the value of information, as well as the effort invested in it. I take pride in what I do. I thought you, of all people, would understand such values, Sae-san.
I apologize. But then, who stole my data? I let my guard down. They're mine. I'm the one who will catch them.
On your feet, inmate. Our master has an important matter to discuss with you. Heed his words well.
First, I'd like to congratulate you for expelling the one proud of their greed. Or so I'd like to say, but something odd seems to have happened. Who knows? However, don't you sense it? The malicious will of another? It seems a contingency has occurred. At this rate, your rehabilitation cannot be completed, though I doubt that will be the case. I truly look forward to seeing how you overcome this predicament.
All right.
We shall meet again.
Time's up, inmate. Hurry up and return to your world.
Is that true?
Listen this time, okay?
We haven't found anything useful as evidence.
I see.
We're hoping to find something more than the calling card, too.
We've confirmed the victim's connection to the Phantom Thieves, at least. Thank you for your cooperation.
Speaking? Huh? They found a calling card in the principal's office, too.
I'm sorry to ask again, but your father hadn't said anything about the Phantom Thieves, correct?
That's right.
Please contact me if something catches your attention. It doesn't matter how trivial it seems. You don't have to force yourself, though. Just anything that comes to mind.
The principal? No one told me about that.
So basically, your group didn't go after Okumura's life. And even the death of Shujin's principal, who we found a calling card for, was the work of another. You don't sound like you're lying. If you wanted to deceive me, you could have easily woven up a much simpler lie than this metaverse. Moreover, your account coincides with my own investigation. Is that even possible if it were made up? And I hate to admit, but with my line of work, I know a false testimony when I hear one. Still, if you set your sights on Okumura based on my intel, it'd be before his name was even ranked. You could have ignored him and targeted some other famous person. Why would you go so far as to further investigate and pursue this criminal? Simple enough. There's still no proof that another suspect exists. That said, it's safe enough to say that you aren't the murdering type.
All right.
But with the subsequent deaths of Okumura and Shujin's principal, the public's opinion changed. Pressed to prove your innocence, your next objective was... What's the matter? Is it a side effect? What in the world did the police inject into you?
Hey, can you hear me? You need to stay focused.
Don't scare me like that. If what you're saying is true, you must tell your side of the story to the end. We'll both be in trouble if your testimony becomes unreliable. Well then, let's move on. At last, we arrive at your most recent crime. You know what I mean, don't you? This calling card was delivered to your latest target, the one you had decided would prove your innocence. It was addressed to Sae Nijima, myself. Now, explain everything to me.
With this, preparations are finally in place. The public has praised them as allies of justice before they strike them back to the ground. Now then, she'll be next. Yes, I've already spoken to Human Resources about it. It will be a heavy responsibility, but I'm certain it'd be an honor for her. The culprits behind the mental shutdown cases she's been pursuing all this time. Indeed. They'll become the criminals we've set them up to be. Just as you instructed.
Damn loud.
Hmm?
Where's Haru?
She's the one that called us, so she'll show up eventually.
Well, even though things have calmed down, she must be occupied with what happened to her father.
Wait, what? But what's up?
People are posting that we killed President Okumura!
So it's begun already.
What?
Think about it. The CEO collapsed the way he did during an apology conference that our group caused.
Still! They were raving about us so much, and now they just treat us like murderers?
What a lightning-fast change of attitude.
They don't know a damn thing about our situation.
Calm down. Not everyone is necessarily saying that.
But there's no way to vindicate ourselves.
Haru!
I'm sorry I'm late. I'm the one who asked you all to make time for me, too.
My condolences. Must be rough.
I'm okay now. I called everyone together because there was something worrying me. Did you all target the principal?
Huh? The principal? You mean ours?
Yes. What makes you say that? Yesterday, a public prosecutor came to my home. It was a woman named Nijima-san. I overheard her saying a calling card was found in the principal's office. Considering that this was right after what happened, it's got to be Shujin's.
It's the first I've heard of it!
Doesn't this all seem weird to you? It may just be my imagination, but I feel as if things are escalating far too quickly after President Okumura's incident.
What do you mean?
Perhaps we may have been set up by the real culprit.
For real?
That could be.
Then we need to catch them as soon as possible.
Hold a moment. Can we assume we've been set up, though? We don't even know their objective.
What else are we supposed to do then?
Let's all calm down for a moment. From what Haru said, even the police are suspecting that the Phantom Thieves are murderers. It wouldn't be wise to carelessly make a move at the moment. We need to act as normal students for now. In addition, we have midterms next week.
Exams? At a time like this?
I envy you, Futaba. Futaba?
Got something on my mind. Gonna go home and look into it.
I wonder what that could be.
At any rate, we need to behave and not draw attention to ourselves. Understood?
For real?
Searching all along.
Impossible.